This allows you to send and receive messages and emails with your mobile. Use of mobile phones in an aircraft over US territory is. Leider entfallen. Ich muss jetzt mal in Wikipedia den Flugscheißer-Modus einlegen. Finden wir noch raus. So, jetzt geht's los. Und zwar wohin?
Next stop is the city of Olympia.
Olympia, Washington.
Right.
Sieht aus wie Island.
Fine Dining hier.
Das sieht aber ehrlich gesagt.
Ich glaube, das ist rum mit dem Fine Dining.
Das ist.
Breakfast, Lunch, Special Orts, dort hier.
Da gehen wir hin jetzt.
Ja, ja, ja.
Das ist unser. Endlich was gefunden. Daily Specials.
Da und hier schon. Läuft auch noch Gravity. Naja. In der 700. Woche. Am besten ein bisschen zurück.
Ja. Today at 1 p.m.
ins Kino gehen, jetzt gleich.
Ist wahrscheinlich alleine drin. Now serving beer and wine. Das ist gut. Breakfast served all day. Klasse.
Do you want toast, English muffin, or biscuit?
Toast.
You want three pancakes?
Yeah. Let's say two.
Two?
Two.
The eggs Benedict.
Okay. Yummy.
Thank you. Jacket Oregon in Oregon. Welcome to Portland, Portland, Oregon.
As you can see,
so Billinger, jetzt kannst du dir die Wahl firm oder soft?
Go for firm.
Car located in the seat in front of you. Please take it out and look it over. If you have any questions or concerns about performing the duties in that row, please let a flight attendant know. We'll reseat you as soon as possible. Again, a full flight this morning. We appreciate your cooperation with our bag stowage. Thank you.
At this time, I would ask our flight attendants to please be seated for takeoff.
Came from the moon. People, lots of people coming out of the walls. People, lots of people coming out of the walls. When there's too many people, ain't no wall.
Thank you. New home and the brand new Chevy rock and roll. See you guys.
So then you have blue skies and minus 10 degrees and having 10 plus and rain and fog the whole day.
Yes, yeah, I agree. It doesn't seem as cold and it seems like this morning.
Yeah, exactly.
So I haven't tried this yet.
My bloody Valentine.
Yeah. Have you seen Stone there down in San Diego?
You have so many different beers.
Oh, of course.
Wasn't that, we've had a beer, Razor 5.
Razor 5. Have you heard that?
Yeah.
Very spicy.
Yesterday night we've had Anchor Steam from San Francisco.
Yes.
Great beer.
Also good.
There you go.
There's no more.
That was
cheers.
Good.
Cheers.
So this is so Laguna Beach, that's where you were today, that's over those hills right there.
Yeah.
So what we'll do is I'm gonna plant some avocado trees down in the bottom, and I'll probably make that. We are gonna redesign the backyard a bit. We'll leave the pool, but we'll probably take most of the rock out. We'll just take this and push it out so there's more living space up here at the higher level where the view's good.
Yeah.
Because you'll see there'll be city lights. And
this is Los Angeles is?
Los Angeles would be, pretty much straight that way. Yeah. That's Long Beach you would be able to see if it were a clearer day. Actually, you can just barely see the top of Ranchos Palos Verdes Mountain.
Mm-hmm.
If you see those buildings right through there, and then just in the very distance, you kind of see a little rise.
Yeah.
The Atlantic Ocean.
That's
so fine.
I'd be right back.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Chris is amazing with wine.
So, how was wife and kids?
Okay.
I like doing the
whoa. Cool.
Let's
see.
And one more.
Chin.
Great position to.
Cheers.
And cheers.
And cheers.
I'm in the great position to be with Pete another week when he's in South Africa.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah, that's. He's a deep freezer?
Yeah.
It's Schombi, das ist ein Kühlschrank. That's a fridge.
Das ist ein Kühlschrank.
Das ist ein Kühlschrank.
That's Tim. Yeah. We've got a long way to go.
It's ugly.
Yeah. Bakersfield.
$120. The best $120 you've ever spent.
Pete, bringst du mir mein Glas mit?
Yeah.
Ganz schnell. Perfect in Deutsch.
Perfect.
Yeah. Yeah, perfect auf Deutsch.
Perfect.
Okay.
Perfect is perfect.
Okay, good. Perfect.
Perfect is perfect.
Mm.
I think it comes from
Latin. Yeah, I'm sure, yeah.
I remember being in the States some years ago and I met some relative and he said to me, Andreas, what means Fahrvergnügen?
Ah!
And I said, right. pleasure to drive. Pleasure to drive. That was a Volkswagen spot, I think. Yeah,
exactly. Yes.
Fahrvergnügen.
Right. Vergnügen. Yeah.
I get a good back massage right now.
Yeah. Good.
Ow!
That's a nice sound.
Yeah. Up real quick. It's not so hard.
Oh, now I see the matte black and the shiny black. Yeah, it's.
Yeah. And it's already pretty warm. Took a quick run out to the canyon. Torsion differential in the back.
Yeah. Unser neues Zuhause.
Sieht doch gut aus, oder? Schombi schön gebaut.
Breakfast at...
In America.
Breakfast in America. On the way to Huntington Beach.
Das ist ein guter Burger. Der Bicahuna Burger. Basis eines jeden amerikanischen Frühstücks.
Ich hab so ein Foto gemacht, eben war es auf Surfbrett, wo es zum Klo ging. Ein Aufkleber drauf, ganz geil.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Panzer Battalion, Tank Battalion.
Yeah, 44.
Oh, that's great.
So, might find a good place in your collection.
Oh, it'll be up front. That's a great one. Thanks, man.
Hey, pleasure.
Pleasure's all mine. You guys are cool.
Your style's slightly changed. You mm-hmm. went away from this clear line defined poster pop and went to a little bit rougher style.
Mm-hmm.
What's the story behind that?
Times change, artistic tastes change. I like to be able to adapt as things change over time.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also tied a lot, my art is tied a lot to clothing design.
Yeah.
And as fashions change season to season, it influences my graphic art, the t-shirt designs I mm-hmm. do, also my own graphics and my fine art.
Mm-hmm.
So as things change over time, as trends change over time, I try to reflect that with my artwork to stay current. Because I don't want to have an old looking style, a dated looking style,
yeah.
when it's compared to other modern
right.
pieces.
What's the feedback of your fans, your collectors, on that?
They like it.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. I like to create it, and I like the feedback. It's been very positive,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of people like my new artwork. And it's been great to see, because through social media and through my sales, recognizing my sales, I can see that people like the new stuff. They like the overlay stuff. They like the rougher finish. And so I'm just producing artwork that I know that people like. I work with Lucky 13, I work with Harley Davidson,
mm-hmm.
and I stay very busy working with them.
Yeah.
And I really enjoy the artwork that I do for
yeah.
Harley Davidson. In 5 years, I'd like to have a reconnection with Europe. I'd like to have art shows, fine art shows over in Europe.
Yeah.
Most likely England, France, all around Germany, Berlin, Hamburg, Frankfurt. And I'd like to be going over there continually.
Yeah.
I used to do that about 10 years ago, and I'd like to have that going again for fine art.
Fehlen nur noch die Weiber jetzt hier in den Puden.
Die Weiber fehlen. Hallo, Schombi.
Schombi, man.
Schombi, man.
Schombi, man.
Bald ist es bei dir auch so auf der Terrasse.
Oh, das Ding ist
got them right here.
Sachen wollen wir nie.
Also unsere Wohnung in San Francisco, kann man nicht meckern, ist eigentlich ein Hotel. In unserem Fall. In unserem Fall eine ganze Wohnung. I'm an unknown individual in an unattended car. Hey, welcome to Chicago or wherever you are. Alcatraz im Hintergrund, das alte Boot und KillBill steht natürlich daneben. luggage is still on the plane. Seconds turn to minutes, minutes turn to hours. Hours could kill a lifetime in a grave with pink flowers.
I've made a flight. The instructor pilot demonstrated there was a 5,000 foot runway, 5,000 feet. And he comes up at 1,000 feet, you know, traffic altitude, so to speak, to the very end of the runway, cuts the engines, takes it down, and lands it. Being 1,000 feet up at the end of the runway. That was interesting, to say the least. I guess he was only about halfway down the runway when he got to the wheels on the ground, because that thing was going almost straight down. Oh. C-46 had some very nice radial engines in it, and I was taking off from Birmingham, Alabama, and we were going to show off a little and make a short takeoff, you know, and pull the nose up about 45 degrees, what have you. Well, fortunately, there was a sergeant sitting in the engineer's seat, which was right behind the pilot and co-pilot, because the co-pilot seat was occupied by a new reservist, who supposedly knew enough about the airplane to be a co-pilot. Well, in the C-46, in the island between the pilot and the co-pilot, had the throttles and RPM and mixture up here, and then there was carburetor heat, levers below that, and then there were two levers for going from to bring in the superchargers. Two lever handles for carburetor heat and two for superchargers. You had to push them in and like that to raise them. But they were all on the same axle, so to speak, through the control panel area. And to get the landing gear up, which is on the right side of the island, it was a funny square knob on the end of it. You push that in and then raise it. Well, here I make this takeoff, gear up, and he's struggling with the damn gear handle. Can't raise it because he didn't know you had to push it in to raise it. So what he finally did when we're up there 700 feet or whatever, he reaches down and pulls up the gear handle with both hands without pressing in the knob. And what happened was, since they were all on the same axle, carburetor heat went all the way hot, the superchargers went all the way up, and I remember seeing the dials go way past the red mark where it's supposed to blow the top off the cylinder. Way past. And fortunately, that only lasted a few seconds, and the engineer, the enlisted man sitting in his seat, he pushed the gear handle back down, and boy, that saved us. It took the carburetor heat off and the superchargers off, level off. But what could have happened when the superchargers went on and they went about 30 degrees, 30 inches of HG past the red mark, is blow the cylinders off. That would have been fatal.
Oh.
Yeah, that would have been fatal. Hey, you took off from Okinawa about, I forget what month it was. But it was, about 4 p.m. And by the time you got over North Korea, it was maybe midnight, something like that. And then they'd drop the bombs, according to Shoran, I think they call it, which was an abbreviation for Short Range Navigation System. Which you had two transmitters outside of North Korea, and they would send out a signal, and this Shoran device, you'd pick up one of the circles of one station and kind of fly the circle around it until you got to the signal from the other one, which would be at a different degree, and where they intersected, that's where you drop the bombs. Never even saw the ground.
And no enemy fire?
Oh, an occasional anti-aircraft, but no aircraft.
And you also told me that you had a lot of hours on the T6. Was it like a plane standing around, and when you've had some time, you can take it and go for a ride?
Almost. You had to check in and schedule it.
Yeah, was it? I told you about my and Pete has a few hours on the T6 too. You did that in Arizona, I think, huh? So I saw in your records also a P-51.
Yeah. P-51, the way they taught us how to fly it, you get in the rear seat of the T6, and you made, 15 landings back there.
Yikes.
And that was supposed to be similar to a P-51. Then they put you in a P-51, and guys, she'll point various things out, and what have you, where to find it, and you just took off on your own. There was no, you know, in those days, or the average days, there was no trainer. Two pilots, P-51.
Yeah. And I saw you've had hours on the B-17, the Flying Fortress.
I have very few hours in the B-17, the Denver Air Force Base. And Denver is 5,652 feet or whatever. Mile high. And C-119 had the throttles set for takeoff, I think it was 60 inches of HG. About halfway down the runway, all of a sudden, the Mercury jumps way past the red line because the turbochargers kicked in automatically. And here, well, had to pull the throttles back to get the below the red line, and that was about half hour. The end of the runway is coming up, and what the hell do we do? Try to stop or take off? Which, well, we finally got off the ground, but boy, that was scary. Every time you press the throttles up to the maximum Mercury, which I think was 60 inches on those engines, after a while they jump up. Like, who the hell did that? Well, that was automatic. You know, it was sensing something at 5,000 feet. And that was close. Finally got off the ground.
Past 18, he was waiting for the bus in his army. So jetzt sind wir hier in der First Class Lounge. Wir essen ein bisschen Sushi und Saté-Spießchen, trinken den besten Chardonnay.
Direkt hinter Billinger im Fenster steht die 747, die uns nach Hause bringen wird.
Business class, thanks for that. And again, everybody, if you can't take your seats, best you can, and stow your items. As far as the flight attendant group, my name is Michael Miller. I am your purser on board, and your purser in charge of the main cabin. That is Vicky Ferguson. And as you know, they had to search around to get a team of flight attendants, so all of us have been thrown together. We were going many other places, Denver, Philadelphia, whatever. But we've all been told to work the flight here for everybody, so we're all ready and give you good service as we can. Flight time is right around 10 hours and 23 minutes. And flight attendants, please do prepare your doors for departure, cross-check, and stand by for all call. Flight attendants, prepare your doors for departure.
From an army of
Turbulent.